Hello friends, welcome to Biology World. Today we are going to start the 8th part of our chapter, Cell, the Unit of Life. In today's part, I am going to discuss about Golgi apparatus and lysosome, which are cell organelles and belong to endomembrane system. So coming to what the Golgi apparatus, let us discuss the basics of the Golgi apparatus. So the Golgi apparatus, it was first observed by a scientist named Camillo Golgi in 1898. Camillo Golgi in 1898, he observed a densely stained reticular structure near the nucleus. Later, he named that structure Golgi bodies on his name. So, in 1898, scientist named Camillo Golgi discovered densely stained reticular structure near the nucleus. So the scientists discovered a densely stained reticular structure near the nucleus. And we know that the nucleus has endoplasmic reticulum attached to it. Since the Golgi apparatus is near the nucleus, we can say that it is in close association with endoplasmic reticulum. And yes, it is 100% in close association with the endoplasmic reticulum. This is a very important question. Why the Golgi apparatus is in close association with endoplasmic reticulum? We'll discuss it, but before that, let me teach you the structure of the Golgi apparatus. A Golgi apparatus under the microscope look like this structure which I'm drawing on board. So the Golgi apparatus, it consists of many flat disc shaped cisternae, and the number of cisternae vary. So 1, 2, 3, so these are 3 cisternae. There are many cisternae, but here I am drawing 3 cisternae to explain you guys. So these structure right here are flat disc shaped cisternae, and the size of this cisternae is 0.5 micrometer to 1 micrometer in the diameter. Now this cisternae has two important portion or the parts. The convex cis or the forming face and the concave trans or the maturing face. So this right here, let us consider this as convex cis, or we can also say as forming face. So this is first portion, and let us consider the other portion as the concave trans or the maturing face. Now let us answer the question why the Golgi apparatus is in close association with endoplasmic reticulum. The major function of the Golgi apparatus is to pack the substance and transport it either in the intercellular spaces or in the cytoplasm. So what is the function of the Golgi apparatus? The function of Golgi apparatus is that it packaging of material and transportation either inside the cell or the cytoplasm. Now the substance which has to be packed in the form of vesicle through Golgi apparatus is released by endoplasmic reticulum, and the substance which is released by endoplasmic reticulum, it first appears on the convex cis and then it travels straight toward the concave or the maturing phase, and it get covered and form a vesicle. Hence the substance is now packed. Later it is transported where the substance is needed to be transported. So this explains why the Golgi apparatus is in close association within the plasmic reticulum. That is to pack the substance easily. So let us consider that somewhere here we have, let us consider this whole board as this cell. And as I said, the cell bear a nucleus and the nucleus has endoplasmic reticulum. Let us consider this whole board as a cell, and as I said, a nucleus which has two membrane, inner membrane and outer membrane, and through outer membrane we found the endoplasmic reticulum, and this is the Golgi apparatus which is in close association with the endoplasmic reticulum. Now substance which has to be packed from the endoplasmic reticulum, it will first appear on the concave cis and will exit from concave trans or the maturing phase, and it get partially or completely packed. Now earlier I have discussed that endoplasmic reticulum, it bear rough endoplasmic reticulum which has ribosome attached to it. Now those ribosome, when they travel through the Golgi apparatus, they get modified and advance as they enter from the convexes and the exit from concave phase, concave trans, they get matured and advanced. So this was a structure and detailed study on the Golgi apparatus. Now the Golgi apparatus is involved in the formation of glycoprotein and glycolipid. So this is also, we can say, a function of the Golgi apparatus, that it is involved in the formation of glycoprotein and the glycolipid. So these were the two functions, and I've discussed everything about Golgi apparatus, and this was the structure on the Golgi apparatus. Now let us discuss about the lysosome, which is another cell organelle. So as we know, lysosome is a cell organelle and it is a membrane bound cell organelle present in eukaryotic cell. Now the lysosome is a product of the Golgi apparatus. That is, the lysosome cell organelle or this structure is formed from the packaging of Golgi apparatus. So first of all, it is formed due to packaging of Golgi apparatus, and also we can say that it is a product of Golgi apparatus. Now a single isolated lysosome vesicle, this lysosome is vesicle in shape, so a single lysosome vesicle is enriched with all type of hydrolysis enzyme. The hydrolysis enzymes are the enzymes which are very acidic or very high and acidic in pH level. So they are enriched with a single isolated lysosome vesicle is enriched with all type of hydrolases enzymes. And these hydrolases enzymes are acidic, or we can say very acidic in pH. Example of these hydrolases enzymes are proteases, carbohydrates, lipases. And these are responsible for digesting. The lysosome itself is responsible for digesting and clearing the waste product. Hence, it is also known as suicide bag of the cell. So, lysosome, it is also known as suicide bag of cell. Why lysosome is known as suicide bag of the cell is because, as I said, the lysosome is enriched with all hydrolysis enzyme. Now, when a cell gets ruptured or breakdown, where there is no more importance of the cell itself secretes the lysosome hydrolysis enzymes, and these enzymes digest the whole cell. And the cell get died and disappear. So we can say that it concluded suicide. Hence, it is also known as suicide bag of the cell. And these hydrolysis enzymes are responsible for the digestion of protein, carbohydrate, and lipases. So the proteases, it digest protein. Carbohydrates, it digest carbohydrate. And lipases, also digest, means it digests lipid, and these hydrolysis enzymes, they also digest the nucleic acid. So nucleic acid is also digested by these hydrolysis enzyme. So this was the concept of the Golgi apparatus and lysosome. In the next part, I am going to discuss about the vacuole through which we are going to end our endomembrane system, and thereafter I am going to start about mitochondria, which is the most interesting topic. Now thank you. If you like the video, then press the like button and don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you get my new updates. Thank you.